Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
Sporjo is offering paid internships for candidates who take the sports score test. If you want to build a career in the exciting world of sports, this is your opportunity to do just that. Click on the link in the description for more details. Hi guys, welcome to another interesting episode. Typically we feature people who've studied business and then gotten into the world of business. We talk about their younger years where they've been in a top campus and the kind of batchmates they had and the kind of education they had in the classroom, etc. Today we are talking to a business professional who's come to his area of business in a very different kind of a route, and he's come there through something he's really passionate about and has played at the highest level in. I'm talking about Mustafa Gauss, a famous tennis player who's moved from playing tennis to managing sports in one of the biggest sports brands in India, JSW Sports. Mustafa, thank you so much for doing this with us.
Oh, thank you. It's really nice to be here, Kunj. Thank you.
Awesome. Mustafa, let's go back in time first. Early in your age, when did you decide that, sports is something that I want to get into? And within that, when did you decide tennis is something that you want to pursue?
My granddad was obsessed with tennis. He grew up in Madras and the sport was very popular there. So he played it all the way through university, because of which my dad and my uncles learned the sport and were good at it. And I was the first grandchild, and by default, I followed them onto the tennis court. We were lucky enough to be living across the road from the CCI club at the time. Started playing tennis when I was four. Always believed that was something I wanted to do. And luckily I was good at it and loved it, and have been obsessed with the sport ever since. So I was a huge Edberg fan, and those clashes, Becker-Edberg rivalry was huge back then. So yeah, I think all of that, watching Davis Cup on TV, Ramesh Krishnan, Leander Paes, watching them win big matches was what got all of us excited, got me excited. And there was never a debate on what I wanted to do.
Mustafa, my next question is about your journey in the world of international tennis. You competed in marquee events like Asian Games and the Davis Cup. The atmosphere, the competitiveness, playing against the best in the world. What were some of your most memorable moments from that time?
The Asian Games, winning a bronze medal as I was 21, 22 at the time. This was my first Asian Games, and we really had no expectations. We were playing doubles, and obviously all the pressure and the limelight was on Leander and Mahesh, and they are the favorites, and they did go on to win gold, and nothing was really expected of the two young boys that was the second team in the draw. And to go out and to beat the favorites, we beat the Uzbeki team in the quarterfinals to get the bronze medal. Was a huge achievement for us. And maybe you're young, you don't take the pressure on, you don't really know what you're really doing. So it was huge. The next match we're playing the Koreans, that were the home team and the favorites. That atmosphere where you have like 15,000-20,000 Koreans cheering against you for every single point in such a big match was a real great experience to learn from and to grow as an individual and as a player. So that was obviously very, very special. And thereafter, there have been many occasions on the ATP tour playing matches. I was in the finals of the Kingfisher Open here in Mumbai at the CCI club. Added special memories because that's where I kind of learned how to play tennis, and then got an opportunity to play an ATP event there.
After you retired from tennis as a much older person, you joined Globo Sports and you transitioned from being a sports person to being a sports manager. So what was that transition like, and what are some of the advantages of being a sports person before becoming someone who's managing sport?
I think the transition at Globo Sport was fairly easy. I think it was a smaller system and a smaller setup, and I had like-minded people around me all the time to kind of helped me on the corporate side of things. The advantages of being an athlete and then being able to speak to athletes and relate to athletes obviously keeps you in a very different position, because when you're talking to another athlete, they know that you're not just talking out of thin air. You've actually experienced the same thing that they're experiencing, or the challenges that they are facing at that point of time, or you've had to make similar decisions that they are needing to make right now. So I think those are the things that really helped me relate and to convey properly and better, and build a better bond with the athletes that we were looking after, or the deals that we were trying to do.
Mustafa, after Globo Sports, you moved to JSW Sports as CEO. That's where you are right now. And you've spent 7 years at the organization doing a variety of sporting initiatives. Tell us about your experience there and talk about some of the top projects that you've done at JSW so far.
So the transition to JSW was a little bit harder. It is a very, very big organization with a lot of systems and processes that are in place. And sport is very new, was non-existent before I joined, and that's when the sports vertical started. So the challenges in that of getting everyone aligned, getting them to support me the way I needed to be supported, was a big task. But that being said, I did have the backing of the promoter family. And as you all will all know, Path is extremely passionate about everything we're doing with sport. And that is a huge bonus to kind of get things done. What I think are some of our biggest achievements, I think the building of the Inspire Institute of Sport, which is a one of its kind in the country, a privately funded Olympic training center, for high performance programs and athletes, was very, very special. Luckily for us, every few years we've had the opportunity of building a new team and making it successful and robust and independent on its own. Right. Setting up Bengaluru FC in 2013 was very special. Winning the I-League in our debut season was something that none of us expected and thought we could do, and we were just the newcomers on the block with a team of rejects, as the newspapers had described us. And we went on to win the league. That was exceptionally special. But adding to that and winning every year and continuing to keep that legacy going is even harder. And I know that as an athlete, that you sometimes win in your first year, but then you never win again because you don't know how to deal with that.
You know what they say, that other products have consumers, but sports has fans. They don't have consumers, they have fans. And that is why the relationship of today's youngsters with sport is very different compared to their relationship with a lot of other interests that they have in their lives. Now, all these passionate youngsters may or may not be fortunate enough to have a CCI across from their house, for example. All of them may not have a very encouraging sporting family that pushes them early. But a lot of them still want to build careers in sport, and they don't get the requisite support or the direction that they require. So what is your take on that, and what is your message to these youngsters who want to make careers in sport?
It was a little different a few years ago, I would say 5-6 years ago. It's very different now, where there are a lot more opportunities. The Indian sports ecosystem has grown a lot. There are a lot more corporates that are committed towards sport. There are a lot more companies that have come up that are committed to sport and building out their sports businesses. So it's very encouraging, is what I would like to say. But at the same time, when I talk to a lot of youngsters, they feel that just because they are passionate about sport, or they played a little bit of sport, or they are obsessed with watching Man U or Barca play every weekend, that they understand what it takes. It's not the case. Right. You need to understand that it's becoming more and more professionalized. You need to understand that there are various verticals within the sports business. So you have to know what is your area of preference, and you have to specialize in that if you want to be part of an organization. You're not there watching games. You're not there to sit and... You're not a fan anymore.
Right.
you are working, and I'm sure all of us will realize that when we go to games as fans, if you went go to an IPL game or you go watch a football game, the people that are working do not get to watch.
Right.
And I know this because whenever I'm at games, I'm invariably going back to my room in the night and watching the highlights, because I miss the Chhetri goal or I miss the Rishabh catch, you know, because I was doing something or talking to someone or dealing with some issue.
Mustafa, what kind of roles exist within the sports industry? What are some of the things that young people can start doing once they join a company like JSW Sports?
Well, there's a whole host, to be honest. There's the industry and the teams are very specialized. You could be part of the marketing system, whether it is on-ground marketing or digital marketing. You could be part of the sales team, where you are out talking to brands, looking at sponsors. And at the same time, you could be part of the ops team, where you're looking at the organization of games and looking after teams and making sure that everything is aligned on that front. And then at the same time, there are a lot of administrative roles. There is legal, there is finance. So there's a whole host. And because of the diverse portfolio that we have, we also have opportunities on data analysis, on athlete management. So there's a whole host of things that we can look at when we're looking at internships within the JSW Sports.
You've tied up with Sportjo to offer internships for some of these candidates who go through the course at Sportjo. So can you talk about what made you decide to offer internships to these students?
When Srini and his team came out and told me about what they're doing, it was a logical fit for us, because having a systematic approach to getting our interns makes life a lot easier for us. Knowing that they would be of a certain level and a certain skill set also makes life a lot easier for us as an organization, because otherwise it's a bit of a hit and miss. I'm hoping and I'm pretty confident that the ones that come through this program would be better equipped to transition on to full-time roles with us.
Who is an ideal candidate for an internship at JSW Sports, Mustafa? What is the ideal makeup of that candidate in your mind?
Well, it starts with being obsessed with sport. And it goes on to someone who is ready to work around the clock on this as and when required, because unlike a lot of other businesses, sport doesn't stop on Sundays and it does not stop at 6 p.m. It's really important to realize that and to understand that.
Any final piece of advice for youngsters who are aspiring to build a career in sports?
Follow your passion, believe in what you want to do, but at the same time, study, learn, and be precise with your areas of expertise. Because if you come to an organization like ours, for example, and you say, I enjoy sport and I want to work in sport, I'm probably going to send you home very soon. You need to know exactly what you're looking for and what you want to do.
Thanks a lot, Mustafa, for doing this with us. We really appreciate it. It's very rare that we get an opportunity to talk to someone who's done so well at the very highest level of sport and then doing so well at the very highest level of business. So really appreciate you taking out time, and I hope students find a lot of value from what you had to say. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's lovely chatting with you guys, and look forward to speaking again soon.
Sportjo is offering paid internships for candidates who take the Sports Core test. If you want to build a career in the exciting world of sports, this is your opportunity to do just that. Click on the link in the description for more details.